वेलकम डियर स्टूडेंट, आई होप यू ऑल आर ओके इन दिस पीरियड। लेट अस स्टार्ट लेसन 4, बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ ज्योमेट्री, क्लास 6 मैथमेटिक्स। हियर वी शैल डिस्कस अबाउट द बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ ज्योमेट्री। What is the geometry? Geometry is the branch of mathematics which deals us with properties and relations of lines, angle, surface and solid. The lines, angle, surface and solid are the geometrical representation in mathematics. The word geometry is derived from two Greek words, geo and meton. The meaning of geo is earth and the meaning of meton is measurement, means इन हिंदी नापना, किसी वस्तु को या किसी भी चीज को, किसी भी मात्रा को नापना ही मेजरमेंट कहलाता है। सो वी कैन से दैट द वर्ड ज्योमेट्री इज डेराइव्ड फ्रॉम द टू वर्ड जियो मीन्स अर्थ एंड मेटोर मीन्स मेजरमेंट, मीन्स मेजरमेंट ऑफ अर्थ in the sense of earth is land, field, plots, farms, etc. In the ancient time, people used geometry to measure the land that they can buy or sell. The fundamental definition of the geometry from which the geometry is originated is point. Everything in the universe originated from point. So we need to discuss about the point. What is the point? Let us see the definition of the point. Point. What is the point? The notation of the point we give this. This is the point. The point neither has length nor breadth nor thickness nor height. This is just used to locate the place and any object. On the map, we locate the places by the symbol using point. So point is only a notation which used to locate the places or any objects on the surface, on a plane. It is called point. The next is line. What is the line? When infinite number of points, means uncountable number of points, arranged in a order, then the representation form, the structure is formed, is called line. Line. If we arrange infinite number of points like this, here I put infinite number of points in a order, then this structure is called a line. this is a line. So we can say that line is formed with infinite number of point. Here I denote this structure by double headed arrow. These two head shows that the line can be extended infinite in the opposite direction. This point represents that this can be goes to infinite and this point represents that this line goes to another opposite direction to the infinite. It is called line. In the line we cannot determine its middle point because we don't know which head of the line can be extended infinitely. Suppose that if I put a point here O and we say that this is the middle point of the line, then stop this head and move this head to infinite, then this point O cannot be remain the middle point. So we can say that the middle point of a line cannot be determined. The next is line segment. Line segment. The meaning of the word segment means part. Whose part? Here I wrote line segment, that means a part of line. If we have two points, suppose that A and B, B two points, then we can join these two points in many ways. Like this, we can join A to B in this manner, or like this, or this. But here we have to find the shortest distance between the point A and B, that is, this is the, this is also a line. Here we join A and B in straight line. Here we can see that this is the shortest distance between A and B. So we can say that this distance is called the line segment because this is the shortest distance between the point A and B. It has two end points, means the point A and B cannot be extended to infinite because it is not a line. It is the part of a line, and the part of a line may be a small part of a line. So it has cannot be extended infinitely because there is no notation of arrow. In the line we have two headed arrow. These arrows show that the end point of the line can be extended infinitely, but in the line segment there is no any arrow. That means the end point of the line segment AB cannot be extended to infinite, and we represent the line segment AB by this symbol. This is known as line segment AB, and we Write the line A B with the symbol double headed arrow. This shows the line AB. I hope you understand. The next point is ray. What is the ray? As we know that the sunlight comes from sun in this way. Just suppose that this circle shows that this is a sun. Suppose that the sun is a fixed point, as we know that, and you have studied in your SST that sun is fixed and earth moves around it. So let us suppose that sun is a fixed point and the light comes from sun in this form. This is the ray of sun. This shows that the ray has one end point and one moving point. The sun is very far away from us, means the sun situated at infinite, and the sunlight comes to us from infinite, means a ray can be extended to infinite in only one direction. So we can say that a ray is a geometrical structure which has one end point and one extending to infinite. Just suppose that this is the fixed point and this is the moving point. This is the fixed point and this is the moving point. This point represents that the ray can be moved, can be extended to infinite, and this is the fixed point which is known as initial point. The fixed point is known as initial point. This is the point A and this is the B. The representation of the ray, the name, we give the name of ray A, B by giving the symbol one headed arrow. This is the ray AB. I hope you understand. The next topic we will discuss in the next video. Please try to understand and revise this definition from your book again. Thank you.